now, and I...
Oh, God, thank you.
And every woman I talked to, when they heard I was interviewing you, said, find out what the diet is. Could you give us a clue about what you're eating these days?
Well, it's my own diet, because I've tried all the fad diets, and I've had a really hard time maintaining. And it's basically the same principle as a lot of diets. It's a high protein, low carbohydrate, and calorie watching. And since, you know, I haven't had anything to drink for 2.5 years, I became a chocoholic. Mm. And when I was feeling sorry for myself or wanted a little reward, it would be the old chocolate. So I lost all the bloat and put it back on in good solid fat. And I thought, you know, after I'd cleaned my act up inside, that it was time to clean up the way I looked, because I really was getting fat.
Why do you think you got fat?
I was unhappy. I was lonely. The last time when I put some weight back on, because I lost 45 pounds 2 years ago, and I put back on about 25 pounds, and I'm a very perverse person. My friends were saying, Elizabeth, you know, you're beginning to put weight back on. And it just sort of crept up on me because, well, I was sick for 3 months, then another 2 months. So 5.5 months out of last year, I was flat on my back with my back. And there was a lot of self-pity involved. Like, oh, poor Elizabeth. Well, let's have a little reward then. And it would be, you know, chocolate, ice cream, and hot fudge, and people would send me candy, and I'd eat the whole box. And that was my reward for poor Elizabeth. When people say, you know, you've got to lose weight, I just put my heels in. Mm. And I thought, I've got to take things out and put them on the table and decide, you know, it isn't just the pain. It isn't being physically immobile. You know, why am I doing this to myself? Why am I so lacking in self-esteem? If I'm lonely, why am I lonely? It's individual to each person that has a problem. I really don't know very many jolly fat women. Inside, there's a skinny woman who's crying. I don't know anybody that enjoys fat jokes. And all the fat jokes about myself that I heard, all they did was make me more recalcitrant and think, well, to hell with you. It's my body. It's the way I look. That's my affair.
Shooting there. In her turn-of-the-century costume and wig, she looks incredible. She had once told me that she didn't mind being fat, but now that she is again a size 6, the truth comes out.
I didn't enjoy being fat.
Really?
No, I hated it, and I hated all the fat jokes. I probably laughed as loud or louder than anyone. But they hurt. Mm. They hurt me a lot. And there was a kind of defiance that I think made me get even fatter. Like it's my business. It's my body. I went through some photos the other day. And they're incredible. I let my hair go. I didn't bother with makeup. I obviously just didn't care. I was quite clearly unhappy. And I think a lot of it was rebellion setting in. I've worked since I was 9. And sort of been told to do this and that. And I reached a point in my life where I thought, no, damn it. If I want to be fat, I'll bloody well be fat.
Did you ever have a life where you were just a little girl?
Before I was in films in England, yeah.
For about 8 years?
Yeah.
That was the only childhood?
Mm-hmm. And really the only time when I wasn't famous.
You know, you're probably the only person, the only actress I can think of whose life can really be told through the films, because you did start so young. The film that we remember when we think of the baby Elizabeth Taylor was when you were 12 years old
and National Velvet.
Oh, well, that was like playing myself.
Have you ever been quiet for a few hours and just think?
All the time. All the time about horses. All day and every night.
I chose the horse for that. Nobody else could ride it in real life other than me.
Hmm.
So the film was just really... I suppose that's why it's one of my favorites.
When you did a film called Cynthia, you got your first kiss in Cynthia. Do you remember?
Oh, I do remember. And I think in real life, I got my own first kiss about 2 weeks before. I was in a panic that I'd be kissed on the screen before I was in real life. And that would have been such a terrible humiliation.
Who was the first kiss?
In real life?
In real life.
A friend of my brother's. It was probably a compassionate kiss.
8 people I think this world has ever seen. He was a dynamo. His energy, his enthusiasm, his sense of curiosity. He was so bright. He was so intelligent. He could communicate.
He told you that you were going to marry him. He was going to marry you, didn't he? Right away. Yeah. I mean, he was very dynamic.
He just sat me down and said, look, the day after I'd announced my separation.
Yeah.
He said, look, don't fool around. You're going to marry me.
You were supposed to be with him on the flight that crashed.
I sure was. It was in my contract. It had been arranged before I even signed the contract to do the film. And I came down with pneumonia and had a temperature of 103. He waited 3 days for me because I had a week off. And finally, he had to leave. And it's funny, he said goodbye to me 5 times, came upstairs. And we held on to each other and cried. And I didn't sleep that night at all. He promised to call me from Albuquerque where they were refueling. And when the call didn't come through at the designated time, I knew.
So you had a sense of foreboding then, that there was just both of you, I guess, didn't you?
When they walked into the room to tell me, I just looked at them and started screaming no.
Beyond the initial shock of that, how do you think that event in your life affected you on the level below that? What stayed with you?
I think it affected me on so many different levels. I think directly after, it affected my behavior in a very destructive sort of way. I became self-destructive. I didn't really care whether I lived or died. I wanted to be with Mike more than anything else in the world. And I think until I almost died of pneumonia, which taught me to appreciate life, that was about 5 years after.
During the filming of Cleopatra, was it?
Yeah,
was
the first Cleopatra. That made me realize that there must be some reason that I wasn't on that plane. That there had to be something that I was meant to do in this world. Otherwise, I would have been on. Mm-hmm. And when I got out of that hospital, I looked at everything with a sense of a different sense of dimension, a different sense of awareness, of hearing. All my senses were so much more acute. Mm-hmm. And ever since then, I've had a passion for life.